Hey folks, Tim here, FT Lock for the love of trains. Welcome back. Helix update construction number 4. And hopefully this will be the final one. So I have to add one more revolution onto my Helix. I was originally going to do about 3.5 turns, but now I'm going to have to go up about 4.5 turns because it just didn't quite look good enough with a grade coming up to the main part of the layout. So, and I didn't want to increase my grade at all, so decided to go up one more level. And well, let's get over there and take a look, see how we're doing. All right, so like I said before, my original plan was to have basically the top of that board right there is the level at the top I needed. And I had to add another revolution to my Helix here, and I've been working on it. Still not quite done. I'm just taking it apart and painting it and laying down some more track up here around the corner. So originally I was going to have it spit out on this third level and then kind of work its way up grade around the corner, but it was too low and I didn't want to increase my grade any higher than 2%, so I thought I had just enough equipment left as far as MDF and track that I went ahead and just went up one more level, and this way it shoots it off just about perfect with my upper level. Okay, some have wondered how I'm attaching these sections together, and no, I'm not using any glue. Of course, I'm using 2 1-inch screws that go through and just barely stick out the bottom, so I won't have any clearance issues. But what I do is when I paint this MDF, and by the way, if I haven't mentioned, I just got a can of paint at a garage sale. Actually, the guy just gave it to me to get rid of it. Any color will do for your Helix. I just needed to paint it to seal in this stuff so it doesn't absorb any moisture being in the basement. But I paint these parts and then I let them sit out and air dry for a little while until the paint's almost dry, maybe a little tacky, and then I put it up on there and then I screw it together. And that really holds the two pieces together quite well, along with the 2 anchor screws or 4 screws per section. And that should prevent any movement this way. And as far as any of my pieces here, I'm not screwing them to the bottom. I'm just letting the weight of the Helix itself hold it down. If I have a problem where it's lifting up or anything, I can put in like an L bracket here and attach it underneath, and that should be enough to pull it down or get it as straight as I need it to be. But as far as it goes right now, I've not had any issues with that. So alright, also what I've been working on is I've been putting on some of the decking for the upper level here and just kind of laying out some track. Yes, I'm going to have a double diamond here. I think that's going to be kind of a neat attraction here right as you walk in the room. But for now, like I said, I've just been starting to lay the decking on the upper level here, and of course I will cut areas out and build hills, and it's not going to be a flat layout, trust me. And yeah, so that's another thing I've been working on down here. I don't know if I showed this on my last video, but I got in this other chunk of fascia here off my old layout. As you can see, it's upside down. I still have trees and stuff I painted floating in the air. And I just kind of threw in some newspaper just to give me an idea of what the terrain could be or what I might do on this bottom section here. But I was able to get that piece in, and now I can start building over the top as well as tying it into this piece that's going to cross over from the other side. Alright, so thought we'd test it out and run a train up the Helix. See how she does. I did pick up another Union Pacific SD60 Proto 2000 on eBay. Really like that one. I got a dirty one and a clean one. Need some windows for that dirty one. And then that Proto 2000 box right over here is a Kansas City Southern one. I can't even tell you how much I paid for that one. You wouldn't believe it if I told you. I think I found somebody sleeping on eBay. So, yeah, everything seems to be running pretty good. Don't mind my my hookup wires here. But this really doesn't have too much trouble. Well, one thing that there's four engines on there, but pulling it up this grade, you know, like I said, it's about 2.2 maybe. So it's not too bad. Let's see. Okay, some people have asked what I use to determine my spacing between where I tied down my tracks. And remember that torpedo level that I showed you that I got to check the grade? This is the case for it. And basically I just would lay the case on the track there and say from one end of the case to the other end of the case was pretty close. And then of course I ran my, did work on my curve, my radius on the outside, and then I just used a little homemade track tool here. Let me grab it quick. A little homemade track tool that I made that I could just set on the track on one rail and keep the offset from the other set of tracks at a consistent basis all the way around. So nothing high tech about this Helix other than the level that I used. That's about the most high tech piece I had here, but it was instrumental to making it happen. Okay, so Helix is just about complete. Maybe just a few other things, fascia around the outside, a few things here and there, but for the most part it's up and operational. Now I can continue working on this upper deck behind me and tie it into that. So once that happens, then I can really start to make headway on the upper deck here and start at least running trains up the Helix and somewhere onto this upper level. So looking forward to that. And I don't know how long it'll be before my next update, but hopefully by then I should have this corner piece done and the Helix tied into the top level. So until then, thanks for watching, and as always, I'm out!